Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to St. Anselm Hayes. It is so lovely to see you, although I have to say, it's a bit odd to not be able to see you, I've just realised. Normally when I stand up here, I can see everybody and we have a little bit of interaction, so this is very odd, but it is lovely because I'm not quite sure how many people they are, and we're obsessed with knowing how many people are in church, so it's lovely to not worry about it this evening. You have a wonderful evening ahead of you, one of Wales's very best male voice choirs, the Torvine Male Voice Choir, and not just because my father sings in it.
Now, where is he?
He said, you won't be able to recognize him because I look nothing like my father. But you have a terrific evening. Now, listen, there is no fire test scheduled for this evening, so if there is a fire, the alarm sounds like this. There's a fire, everybody should leave. And it's a completely automated system. You can leave through the doors you came in or through the doors here on the side. The toilets are here and in the church hall, which is through those doors, so do make use of those. At the interval, we'll be selling teas and coffees to raise money for the work of the parish. And you'll remember, those of you who came last year, I told the story of the kind of work we do here. And we had a gentleman come who had been homeless, and he had an interview for a job, and we were able to buy him a suit and take him to the interview and help him through. Well, I can tell you that that gentleman got the job, and he is still working in that place now, thanks to your generosity and your love. We continue to do that kind of work. We help the most desperate people in Hayes, and anybody who has spent any time in this church will have seen the people who come through the door asking for help time and time again. It is your support that enables that. That's a very long way of me saying that when you buy your tea and coffee for £1 and £1.50 for a hot chocolate and 50p for a biscuit, you'll be asked if you would like to make a donation. And we would be very grateful. We accept all major credit cards, but we can only deal with paper money. So without further ado, I would like to introduce you to Father Josiah. Father Josiah, well, he's waving at the back, but it's no good because there's no light. Well, I will introduce you to him properly after the interval, but Father Josiah is our new mission priest. So we've been going great guns here at St. Anselm, and we are growing, and it's just wonderful. So the diocese have put another priest here in St. Anselm for us to go out and do amazing things. So I've been going on a long time now, I'm sorry boys, but I would like to introduce you to Stephen, the musical director of the Torvine Male Voice Choir, who will start this evening's concert.
Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I suppose the first thing to do is to welcome our choir this evening. Please welcome the Torvine Male Voice Choir. At the piano, we have the multi-talented Miss Penny Hughes. And how are we all this evening? All right. You're very good. Well, let's see if we can't sort of make it a bit better than that, because I'd like you to think that everybody was really in great spirits and having a wonderful evening. So we're going to start off by singing a lovely little song, and it's just called Love Is All Around. Thanks, Ben.
I feel it in my fingers, I feel it in my toes. When love is all around me, and so the feeling grows. It's written on the wind, it's everywhere. kind of get to thinking of all the things we said. You gave your promise to me as I gave mine to you. I need someone beside me in everything I do.
Well, thank you very much. We're going to continue with a song from possibly one of the most famous films ever. Anyone want to guess what the film might be? Yeah. Oh, more famous than that, but a lot older than Star Wars. It's The Wizard of Oz. And we're going to sing that wonderful song, Over the Rainbow.
That's it.
Now, as you can see, ladies and gentlemen, the choir, how can I put it politely, we're not now in our first flush of spring. So we're going to have to do little spots and then give them a chance to have a sit down. So we've got a few little treats for you as we go along. So we're going to finish our first little spot with a very pretty little song from another part of the world, somewhere in America. It's a river, a bit like the Thames you've got in London. But this one's called Shenandoah. Thank you. So, ladies and gentlemen, as I said, I'm going to have to give the boys a little sit down from time to time. So I'm going to introduce the first of our soloists now, a young chap whose granddad's been in the choir for a couple of years now, and he's going to introduce his own numbers, and he's a bit of a character, so you never know what he's going to say next. But hopefully we know what he's going to sing next. So please welcome our friend Travis.
Thank you for the warm welcome, and thank you everybody for being such a lovely audience so far. the night is young. It's a great pleasure to be here. I'm truly honoured, very cathartic actually. I'm 22 years old and I joined this very choir when I was 14. And through many years of working with this choir, being educated, being transformed, I am very lucky to say I am a professional actor and singer now, something I never dreamed could ever be possible. I'm performing here today a song that has been with me for a long time now, considering it was through this very choir that I was able to realize my love of classical music. And of course, it feels, you can't help but feel like in this day and age it's a dying breed. You turn on Radio 1, Radio anything, you're not going to hear anything the way it was before, which I personally feel is the best ways about it. But one of the few, I'm not going to say pioneer, one of the very few people these days in modern music that are actually keeping that classical feel alive is an amazing, truly phenomenal singer, performer, called Josh Groban. And does anyone know Josh Groban? Does anyone enjoy? Isn't he great? And considering Josh Groban was the same age as me when he first released his very beginning solo album, I believe it only makes sense here today for me to open my solo spot by singing one of his first ever classical songs, Broken Vow. I hope you enjoy. Tell me his name, I want to know. The way he looks and where you go. I need to see your face. I need to understand why you and I came to an end. Tell me again, I want to hear. Who broke my faith in all these years? Who lays with you at night when I'm here all alone? Remembering when I was your own. I let you go, I let you fly. Why do I keep on asking why? I let you go now that I've found a way to keep somehow more than a broken vow. Show me the tears you never shed. Tell me the words I never said. Give me the touch, the one you promised to be mine. Or has it vanished for all time? I let you go, I let you fly. Why do I keep on asking why? I let you go now that I've found a way to keep somehow more than a broken vow. I close my eyes and dream of you and I, and then I realize there's more to love than only bitterness and lies. I close my eyes. I'd give away my soul to hold you once again. And never let that promise end. I let you go. I let you fly. Now that I know, I'm asking why. I let you go. Now that I've found a way to keep somehow more than a broken vow. Thank you. After the choir boosted my confidence to the absolute, well, really, I got too confident, really. They really had to knock me down a peg. They are capable of doing so, believe me. Trust me, it's the way of the Welsh in us. After all that, I moved on to doing small hall tours, as many performances as I could. Being a person on the autistic spectrum, I struggle with depression and anxiety, which is a very common thing these days, especially younger people. When I branched into musical theatre, I found a home there that made me feel truly comfortable. One of my favourite musicals is one that just leaves you with such a happy spark after watching it. It's one of the few beautiful traditional things that just leave you happy. My Fair Lady, written in 1965. The song I'm going to be performing next is one of my personal favourites from the show, sung by a character called Freddie, who falls in love with our main heroine, the beautiful Eliza Doolittle, with the first glance, as you do in musical theatre, the hero sees the heroine and instantly falls in love after 5 minutes. Obviously, restraining orders didn't exist back then, so I hope they did anyway. And Freddie, even though he has this very naivety about him, considering his wealth and being an aristocrat, he's also deep down such a loving, kind spirit. And I just love the song, so I'm going to perform it. There you go. Penny, please. When she mentioned how her aunt bit off the spoon, she completely done me in, and my heart went on a journey to the moon. When she talked about her father and the gin, and I never saw a more enchanting farce than the moment when she shouted, "Move your blooming!" No. Imagine if someone shouted that out. Wouldn't that be? I have often walked down the street before, though the pavement always stayed beneath my feet before. All at once am I several stories high, knowing I'm on the street where you live. Are there lilac trees in the heart of town? Can you hear a lark in any other part of town? Does enchantment pour out of every door? No, it's just on the street where you live. And all the towering feeling, just to know somehow you are near. The overpowering feeling that any second you may suddenly appear. People stop and stare, they don't bother me, for there's nowhere else on earth that I would rather be. Let the time go by, I won't care if I can be here on the street where you live. People stop and stare, they don't bother me, for there's nowhere else on earth that I would rather be. Let the time go by, I won't care if I can be here on the street where you live.
I told you I had a few treats for you, didn't I? That was just one of them. There's more. Okay, back to the choir now, and we're going to mix a bit of Welsh with a bit of Maori. We did this one last year as well, I seem to remember. The Maori tune is called Pakare Kariana. But the Maori words are a bit difficult to learn. And we worked out that the words of Calon Lan, the wonderful Welsh hymn tune, fit perfectly. So they're the ones we're going to use. So we're going to sing the Maori tune with the Welsh words. So please enjoy our version of Pokari Kariana.
Oh,
Right. So we've been quite gentle so far. So I think it's time we went a bit faster. We've got quite a lot of room around here today. So, have we got any dancers in? Any dancers? There was a couple in the back, I think. A couple of hands went up, I think. Well, I'm looking for somebody who can do a dance called the Bossa Nova. This is only the 42nd concert I've done it in, and I've still yet to find somebody who can do it. So we're going to sing Blame It on the Bossa Nova, and if anybody can do it, it'd be great to see you out the front having a dance. Seriously, here we go.
Bye, Fred.
Thank you. So, talking of little treats, I did say at the beginning that on my right, your left, we have the multi-talented Penny Hughes. I say multi-talented because at the moment she's in the middle of writing her own ballet. She looks after animals. She accompanies about 4 choirs. And now she's going to play solos. Which one's first, Pen? Yeah, pun? Yeah. Give me a clue. Huh? Well, give me a clue. Which one he was doing first? No, it's not chopping at all. Not shopping either. You do that on Saturdays, mornings. By Chopin, the waltz in A flat. Please welcome Penny Hughes. Bit special, eh? Yes? Penny Hughes. And do you know what is even more fascinating? I found a little spot over there where I could actually see hands. Couldn't keep up with them. Amazing. Anyway, back to the choir. We're going to finish this first half off, and then obviously, please, ladies and gentlemen, tonight is all about making sure that the church can continue its work. So please give very generously to the teas and coffees and everything during the interval. We've got three more numbers, and we're going to start off with just a pretty little song. It doesn't last long, and it's called Let It Be Me.
I bless the day.
Thank you. And so, no, I've got two more to go yet.
You said you've got into that. I've come up. I've got the teapot's gone on.
I told you we were doing three.
I just was.
Oh, you are listening, see? See, so keen to get that teammate. See. Anyway, the next one, ladies and gentlemen. You know, if you do ask that question, or let it be me, and they say no. This next song is what you have to do. Just steal away.
Steal away.
So we're going to finish the first half now. This is the last one this time, yes? And this one, we're going to do in two different languages. We're going to start off in a Southern African dialect called Hausa. And then we're going to sing in English. We're only going to do a little bit of Hausa, because I can't say it very well, and I certainly can't pronounce half the words. But we'll do a little bit of that, and then we'll go into the English. The song is simply called Marching. I'm sure you will know the tune, and I'm sure you will know parts of it. And if you do, and you want to have a little quiet sing-along, please do. So here we go. We're going to finish off the first half with Marching. Thanks, Ben.
I was listening, I promise. Well, what about that? What a great first half, and even more better stuff to come in the second half. Thank you very much, Brian. So for the next 15, 20 minutes or so, we'll be selling teas and coffees from our new coffee cart, which is a motorbike with a coffee machine attached to the back of it, which for those of you that know me is, of course, that's what I've bought. So it's going to go out and about in Hayes. It's going to go out into areas where people are struggling. We're going to be giving away tea and coffee. It's also going to go out when there are incidents in Hayes, which sadly happen too often. So when the police are here and that kind of stuff, and they need tea and coffee and keeping going, that's what it's for as well. So you'll be helping us support that work as well. So do come and have a tea and coffee. We also have lovely hot chocolates. We haven't quite perfected the method of selling it all yet, so be patient with us. Thank you very much for a wonderful first half.
Thank you. going to learn Nutcracker by Christmas.
That's all tidy, it's difficult.
Well, that's good. I don't think anyone left in the interval. That's good, boys. Well done. Nobody left in the interval, so you're doing all right. And you all got a cup of tea or coffee or hot chocolate. How were they?
Good.
I need more practice. I'm glad you worked, though. We did 56 drinks in a short period. So, right, thank you very much for your patience and support and good donations. Everybody, this is Father Josiah, who is our new mission priest here in Hayes. You'll see him out and about. Doing amazing work. If you see him on the street, grab hold of him, and he'll help you. He has an absolute heart for helping those most in need. And he's out and about, particularly on the Red Brick Estate, as all of those changes happen. So if you see him, just give him a pat on the back. Offer to pray for him, because he needs it, because he works with me. Right, without any further ado, the Torvine Male Voice Choir for their second half.
As you may know, we are from that little part of the very west of England, commonly called Wales. And so we're going to start the second half with a piece of music called O Gymru, which simply means from Wales. It's a little romanticised picture of somebody's thoughts about the country, and they talk about it being in their heart. They talk about it being the sunshine of their life and all the rest of it. And so there's some lovely images in there, which may fall a little bit on deaf ears, in as much as, unless we've got a couple of Welsh speakers in here. How many speak Welsh? One. Dim ond un. Just one. Okay. So here we go. O Gymru.
Jesus,
Did you understand it? No. Never mind. Still a good tune. We're going to go on to something that you will understand because it's in English. I think. And it's a lovely little folk song, and it's called The Flower That Shattered the Stone. Following this, we've got another treat for you. Thank you very much. As I said, we've got a nice little, another little treat for you now. Now, your wonderful priest said earlier that his dad sang in the choir, and he looks nothing like his dad. Well, I'll leave that to you, because his dad is your next treat. So please welcome your vicar's father, our Michael. Come on, Mike.
Good evening. Right, the first song I'd like to sing is called My Little Welsh Home. Okay. I am dreaming of the mountains of my home, of the mountains where in childhood I would roam. I have dwelt neath southern skies, where the summer never dies, but my heart is in the mountains of my home. I can see the little homestead on the hill. I can hear the music of the rill. There is nothing to compare with the love that once was there in that little homestead on the hill. I can see the quiet churchyard down below, where the mountain breezes wander to and fro. And when God my soul will keep, it is there I want to sleep, with those dear old folks that loved me long ago. Thank you. You probably know the next song very well. It came out in the 50s and the 60s. It's called I Believe. I believe for every drop of rain that falls, a flower grows. I believe that somewhere in the darkest night, a candle glows, thank you. Every time, I've lost it now. Can we start again, please? I believe for every drop of rain that falls, a flower grows. I believe that somewhere in the darkest night, a candle grows. I believe for every drop of rain that falls, someone will come to show the way. I believe above the storm, the smallest prayer will still be heard. I believe that someone in the great somewhere hears every word. Every time I hear a newborn baby cry, or touch a leaf, or see the sky, then I know why I believe.
Thank you.
Oh, go on.
Do you know that one?
No.
So, we're now going to sing a song. And there's very few of them left, I think. Ooh. It's not in that key.
We don't have many left in our area anyway. It's simply called Working Man. And unfortunately, as you said, jobs are getting scarcer and scarcer. And so the poor old working men are getting fewer and fewer. So the best thing we can do now is sing about them. So here we go. Thanks, Fenn.
He's a working man I am, and I've been down underground, and I swear to God if I ever see the sun, or for any length of time, I can hold it in my mind, I never again will go down.
That was a bit different, wasn't it? I hope you liked the little bit where we decided to throw the Welsh National Anthem into the last couple of choruses as well. So that was something they challenged me to do, so I did it. Okay, our next song was recorded by the Righteous Brothers and featured in the film Ghost. and it's called Unchained Melody. So sit back, put your feet up, and enjoy.
Thank you.
Enjoyed her in the first half. So Penny is now going to play another little solo for you, and on this occasion I'm going to ask her to explain it to you, simply because if I do it I'm going to get it wrong as usual. Do you want to come in?
No. I don't need a mic.
That's true.
Excuse my French, I don't speak French. It's all
Lovely story, isn't it? And you can see it all in your mind as you're hearing the music. Absolutely fabulous piece of music. Thanks, Penny. The choir are going to continue now, and we're going up market. We're going to the world of real opera, to the pen of Giuseppe Verdi and his wonderful opera Nabucco. And we're going to sing the song of the Hebrew slaves who are trying to escape. And it's called Speed Your Journey. So we've done a bit of Horsa, we've done quite a lot of English, we've done a bit of Welsh, so we'll do a bit of Latin. And this one is basically more than a simple blessing. It's from a bigger work by a Welsh composer called Robert Arwyn from Cardiff. And it's, as I said, it's a bigger work. I'm not sure what it is. And this is the Benedictus from his other work. So please enjoy Robert Arwyn's Benedictus. Thank you. And again, we're going to bring back our other soloist from the first half as our final, before our final spot. Please welcome back our Travis. Come on, Trav. He's got something special for you this half, I'm sure.
The joys of being over 6'2". I want to say thank you again to everybody. I had the absolute pleasure of speaking to some of you during the break, and I just, again, want to thank all of you for just being an extraordinary audience. And I know it's not my place to say it, but I'm so grateful for all of you. You're all wonderful. This is a song that, if you were here last time the choir was here, you would have heard it sung by the choir. I've nicked it. This is a spiel that Steve did gloriously last time, so now it's my turn. This is a song called Tell My Father. It's a song from a show called The Civil War, a fantastic show that, believe it or not, lasted 13 performances on Broadway. Would you believe it? A Broadway show, with all that money, the rehearsal time and everything put into it, all that, 13 performances. The story itself is a tragedy, and the story of the song is a tragedy. The song is about this young lad, this young boy, this soldier fighting on the battlefield, and he's gravely wounded. He's dying, and he has nobody there but his good friend. And he's saying to his friend, "Please send a message to my father. Tell him that I did not perish in cowardice. I did not weep. I fought bravely. I made him proud. I made the country proud, and I rest in nothing but peace." Unfortunately, this is the only song that survives properly in people's memory from this beautiful show, in my opinion. Through the greatness of solo singers such as Bryn Terfel, Alfie Bowe, John Owen Jones, Michael Ball, and of course, fantastic male choirs like the one behind me today, this song has risen from the ashes like a phoenix. And here it is to make you all cry. Tell my father. Thank you, Penny. Tell my father that his son didn't run or surrender, that I wore his name with pride as I try to remember. You are judged by what you do whilst passing through. As I rest in fields of green, let him lean on your shoulder. Tell him how I spent my youth, so the truth can grow older. Tell my father when you can, I was a man. Tell him we will meet again, where the angels learn to fly. Tell him we will meet as men, for with honor did I die. Tell him how I wore the blue, proud and true, through the fire. Tell my father so he'll know I love him so. Tell him we will meet again, where the angels learn to fly. Tell him we will meet as men, for with honor did I die. Tell him how I wore the blue, proud and true, like he taught me. Tell my father not to cry, then say goodbye. thankfully, my final song for you this evening, ladies, gentlemen, and everybody else. Never know these days. It is not as depressing as that one. Thankfully, it's quite more triumphant, should you say, more determined. It's from what pretty much anyone would consider to be definitely the most successful and most inspiring, I'd say, musical of all time. Of course, it is The Sound of Music, of course. No, Les Miserables, of course. Les Miserables, absolutely extraordinary music all around the board. And when a young chap like me comes here anywhere and they say they're going to sing a song from Les Mis, you'd instantly sing something that tugs on your heartstrings, like Bring Him Home, or something that makes you think and ponder, like Empty Chairs and Empty Tables, or maybe something that will make you cry, like I Dreamed a Dream. But I'm going to go for something that not a lot of people my age would go for. I'm going to sing a song that is actually sung by the closest thing that the show has to a villain. That is, of course, I'm talking about Stars from Les Miserables, sung by Javert, or Javert, as they would put in the theatre, kind of put the drama in there. This song comes. Now, if you take the context, if you put the context into the song, this is about a man with severe mental problems talking about how he's going to spend the rest of his life tracking down a man because he stole a loaf of bread. Not as triumphant as you'd want, but if you take context out of this song, it is about a man who is finally coming to terms with what he wants to be, what he wants to strive for and stand for in life. A man who has finally, after all tragedies in life, after all the barriers that have been put in his way, he finally knows now what he needs to do. It is about determination, it is about triumph, it is about striving for what you want no matter what. And every human being can sympathize and empathize and identify with that. Javert goes up to the bell tower after Jean Valjean escapes from him once again, and he gives his admiration and his promise to the stars. Thank you, Benny.
There, out in the darkness, a fugitive running, fallen from God, fallen from grace. God be my witness, I never shall yield till we come face to face, till we come face to face. He knows his way in the dark, mine is the way of the Lord. Those who follow the path of the righteous shall have their reward. And if they fall as Lucifer fell, the flame, the sword. Stars, in your multitudes, scarce to be counted, filling the darkness with order and light. You are the sentinels, silent and sure, keeping watch in the night, keeping watch in the night. You know your place in the sky, you hold your course and your aim, and each in your season returns and returns, and is always the same. And if you fall as Lucifer fell, you fall in flame. And so it must be, for so it is written on the doorway to paradise. Those who falter and those who fall must pay the price. Lord, let me find him, that I may see him, safe behind bars. I will never rest till then. This I swear, this I swear by the stars.
Are we all right? Nobody needs counselling. One's already dead and the other one's about to jump off a bridge. Gah. I'm sorry guys, the next one ain't going to get any better. We're doing Elvis's American Trilogy. And guess what? If I go to the middle of it, what does it say? So hush little baby, don't you cry. You know your daddy's bound to die. So there we go. It really doesn't get much better, does it? It's still a good song, though, so please enjoy the American Trilogy.
Thanks, Ben.
Glory, glory, hallelujah.
Well, at least after all those deaths, we had a good glory, glory, hallelujah to finish, didn't we, eh? We're going to finish now. We've got one more song, and it's a nice little song, quite suitable for church, I think. It's got a bit of This Little Light of Mine in it, but it's also got that wonderful song, Amen. So we're going to put those two together and do a little song to finish. We just call it Amen. So that's a good way to finish most services, isn't it? And concerts. So here we go. Amen.
Perfect.
I didn't expect to need this one, but here we go. Ladies and gents, that's been a fabulous audience. We will do one more. This one is...
I'm going to get this one right. I'll always get it wrong. Yes.
This one is from a show that was called The New Moon. Not Blue Moon, as I always keep saying. No, The New Moon. And it's all about sailors. But I don't use it as sailors. This is all about this wonderful choir behind us who go around raising money for charities going to old people's homes, bringing entertainment to people who don't get much entertainment, and they give up their own time and they pay their own way to come out on these trips to actually entertain people. Absolutely fabulous bunch of men, and this song is simply called Stout Hearted Men, and that's what each and every one of them are.
Thanks, Ben.
Fantastic, but without Penny and Steve, who look after us and coach us and bring us through, and obviously our soloists tonight, Travis and Mike, thank you very much. Thank you very much, and we're thoroughly enjoying our St. David's Day concert. Thank you very much.
Well, there we are. Now, who knows what amen means? It means we all agree. So amen, amen, alleluia, boys, because we all agree that was an amazing night. Thank you so, so much. Now, I just want to say, you all know that we do this concert to raise money for the church, and I've gone on about it a lot, but I want you to consider that these boys, these lads from South Wales, have paid to come here tonight. We haven't paid them. We haven't paid for their hotel. We haven't paid for their coach. We haven't paid for anything. All we've done is given them some sandwiches, and I'm about to give them some, can I just say, particularly good butter curry, butter chicken curry. But that's all we do. They pay to come here to do this, to raise money, and I just think that is a astounding. And so from the bottom of my heart, thank you so much for the help that that you are giving to people who are in such desperate need here. Thank you. Saint, it is, yeah, St. David's Day on Wednesday. On Wednesday, St. David's Day on Wednesday. It's a feast in Lent, which means that you are obligated under religious law to eat a knickerbocker glory. I don't make up the rules, I just live by them. Thank you very much for coming out this evening, and we see you all again soon. Good night, God bless. Have a safe journey home.
Because of that talking you gave me before.